The quality of air that we breathe is something that many people take for granted. Here, at the American Lung Association, they're working hard towards cleaner air and a healthier Maine.
The American Lung Association here in Maine is located in Augusta, and we are a nonprofit organization that is looking to fight lung disease here in the Northeast and also to really educate people about how they can improve their lung health.
One of the main focuses of the American Lung Association is the air quality and how to clean up the pollution in our environment.
The major types of pollution we have are particle pollution or soot. And that is very dangerous. The small pieces of that soot can go through the lungs into the bloodstream and actually result in heart attacks and heart disease, as well as lung disease. And then with ozone, that's a common pollutant in the summer.
The American Lung Association also offers assistance to help those in trying to quit tobacco.
It was an online freedom from smoking program, and people can go to our website and sign up for that, that program. We've had a lot of success in the state. Been one of the most successful states in the country in reducing smoking rates, and that's been a battle that will continue into the future as the tobacco industry develops new and more sophisticated ways to addict our kids. Maine has made tremendous efforts. You really have to go a long distance to try to find a place where you can smoke inside in the state of Maine. There's not very many places, and we've been nationally recognized for our work there. Fortunately, we're one of the few states in the country that bans smoking in cars when children are present, and we just think that's a no-brainer. That should be just common sense, but unfortunately it isn't, and Maine was one of the first states in the country to address that. But we've learned a sad lesson that if we don't pay attention to tobacco, the industry has not gone away. It's developed new products and it'll be coming back and it will continue to addict people. So we can't let our guard down.
The Trek Across Maine is the premier fundraiser for the American Lung Association, which is a 3-day, 180-mile bike ride across the state.
The Trek Across Maine is an amazing event. It's the largest fundraiser that any American Lung Association chapter has in the country. It's almost a $2 million operation. It's been going on for over 25 years.
Every individual has to raise a minimum of $500, and a lot of people raise more than that. I think our average pledge is probably around $800. And the money raised really goes towards research and education and legislation.
The money that they're raising to support our mission will not only impact their personal health, but their friends, their family, everyone in the state of Maine is going to benefit from the work that the Lung Association is doing.
Well, I think there's a variety of reasons why people trek. Either it's in their bucket list or on their bucket list. They want to turn their life around and become healthier. They want to lose some weight. They have a medical condition themselves. They might have asthma or have a family member who has asthma or COPD. They might be cycling in memory or in honor of a loved one who has a lung disease. And some of them just ride because it's a lot of fun.
Anybody can ride the trek. We encourage all ages, all physical abilities, really anybody that has, you know, a passion for it or a desire to go out there and challenge themselves. With the right training and the right attitude, really anybody can participate.
We need 750 volunteers. They're critical for the trek to actually take place.
I would say one of the most touching stories came from a couple of years ago, and we heard about it after the trek, and it was a first-year trekker. She'd never ridden before, and she came to one of the large hills that we have on day one of the trek and really just didn't feel like she was going to be able to make it up. She got halfway up the hill, she was tired and ready to get off her bike and just walk it, and all of a sudden another woman rode up beside her and started just talking to her and coaching her through and telling her she could do it. And it turned out the woman that was actually coaching her up the hill was battling cancer, and she had just had a chemotherapy treatment the week before. And she was basically just sharing her story with this woman and telling her, you know, if I can do it, you can do it, and my son is riding with me. And it really just pushed the woman who was struggling to make it up the hill. And we just thought that was so inspiring, that trekkers are all there to really help each other through, and they know that they're working towards a common goal.
With touching so many lives throughout Maine, it's easy to see that the people of the American Lung Association take pride in their work.
One of the things that makes me the most proud to work at the ALA is basically just seeing the lives that we impact and then seeing the joy and accomplishment in people's faces when they participate in the trek and they finish.
For over 25 years, I've had the privilege of working with some of the best volunteers and staff that anybody could ask to work with. And I'm most proud that by working together with them, we've made a significant difference in tobacco use in this state and tobacco policy.
Want to know more about the American Lung Association? Log on to their website. It's lungne.org, or there's a link on myfoxmaine.com.